You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
It is Friday, the 20th of August, 2021. 20th week in ordinary time, and today we keep the memorial of Saint Bernard, abbot and doctor of the church. Saint Bernard was a remarkable monk, preacher and theologian. Born in 1090 in France, he became a Cistercian monk at the Abbey of Clever. A natural leader, he was soon named abbot and transformed the abbey into a center of renewal and holiness. Through his preaching and writing, he influenced many people, including popes and kings. Bernard traveled throughout Europe in order to heal divisions among Christians and to direct them in the path of holiness and communion. His theological works reveal the depths of his spirituality and commitment. He died in the year 1153. Let us pray. O God, who made of the abbot Saint Bernard a man consumed with zeal for your house and a light shining and burning in your church, grant through his intercession that we may be on fire with the same spirit and walk always as children of light. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Our first reading will be taken by Mercy Musvene Mushangwe, celebrating her 40th birthday today, a Daily Bread member from Victoria Falls, Zimbabwe.
First reading. Naomi returned, and Ruth the Moabitess with her, and they came to Bethlehem. The beginning of the book of Ruth. Ruth chapter 1, verse 1, 3 to 6, 14b to 16, and 22. In the days when the judges ruled, there was a famine in the land, and a certain man of Bethlehem in Judah went to sojourn in the country of Moab, he and his wife Naomi and his two sons. But Elimelech, the husband of Naomi, died, and she was left with her two sons. These took Moabite wives. The name of the one was Orpah, and the name of the other Ruth. They lived there about 10 years, and both sons died, so that the woman was bereft of her two sons and her husband. Then she started with her daughters-in-law to return from the country of Moab, for she had heard in the country of Moab that the Lord had visited his people and given them food. And Orpah kissed her mother-in-law and went back, but Ruth clung to her. And she said, "See, your sister-in-law has gone back to her people and to her God. Return after your sister-in-law." But Ruth said, "Entreat me not to leave you or to return from following you. For where you go, I will go, and where you lodge, I will lodge. Your people shall be my people, and your God, my God." So Naomi returned, and Ruth the Moabitess, her daughter-in-law, with her, who returned from the country of Moab. And they came to Bethlehem at the beginning of barley harvest. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our gospel passage will be taken by Father Hopeful Kafumo, celebrating his birthday today, a Daily Bread member from Mutare Diocese in Zimbabwe.
You shall love the Lord your God. Your neighbor is yourself. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Matthew chapter 22, verses 34 to 40. At that time, when the Pharisees heard that Jesus had silenced the Sadducees, they came together, and one of them, a lawyer, asked him a question to test him. Teacher, which is the great commandment in the law? And he said to him, You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the great and the first commandment. And a second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments depends all the law and the prophets. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today and tomorrow we are going through the book of Ruth, which is acting as a bridge as we get back to the New Testament on Monday. The book of Ruth is a simple but beautiful story of ordinary life. The most striking feature is how the ordinary event of the birth of a child takes an extraordinary significance. Thus, the faith of a Moabite woman, Ruth, and her commitment to her mother-in-law leads her marriage to Boaz and the birth of a son who becomes the ancestor of Jesus of Nazareth, the birth of David. We don't know the author, but what we know is that this book was written after the exile experience. Remember when the people of Israel went into exile, they came back from exile with foreigners. They had mixed marriages. And some of those foreigners they came with became more committed as Jews than even the Jews themselves. And this is the message that we have in the book of Ruth. A non-Israelite becomes a faithful Israelite. A woman is faithful at a time when Israel is not faithful. We see this happening in our families. We see this happening a lot, even in our marriages, where I marry a non-Catholic and the person I marry who is not a Catholic becomes a stronger Catholic than myself. Shame upon you if that is what is happening. And yet we see this happening very often in marriages. You marry somebody and you make that person become a Catholic, become a Christian, and you even stop going to church. She starts even encouraging you to remain faithful. We want more roots in our lives today. People who are able to maintain their faithfulness to the end. We see another element in the life of Ruth, which we have to learn. Many of us who become widowed. When you become a widow, it doesn't mean that you should cut your ties from the family you married. No, that is a permanent relationship. Many of us even forget about that family, even when we have children in that family. No, that is not a Christian approach. That is not a Christian way of relating to people. When you have been married in a family, even when death separates you, you don't cut the bonds from that family. You may even get married in some other family, but you still remain connected to that family. Look at Ruth. Your people shall be my people. Your God will be my God. This is a Moabite who becomes a Jew. And we want to learn something from this great woman, Ruth, whose name has been mentioned even in the New Testament in the genealogy story, where we see Matthew in chapter 1 mentioning five women. She's among the five women who have been mentioned in the story of how God works even in those who are considered as outsiders to achieve his goal. You may be feeling an outsider because you just recently became a Christian. You just recently became a Catholic. And somehow there's that feeling, oh, I'm just a convert. No. Ruth even was counted in the genealogy of Jesus Christ, a foreigner, an outsider. There is no outsider when it comes to commitment. If you have found Jesus, if you have found God, please feel like you were born one. That is how Ruth felt. There is only one thing that is going to make you feel like you were born one. Love. Living your life with love. Ruth followed Naomi because of love. And this love is the center of the message we have today in the gospel passage. The Pharisees heard that Jesus had silenced the Sadducees about the life to come, and they gathered, they wanted to corner him in his knowledge, so they called the scribes to come and question him. A lawyer asked him and tested Jesus, "Teacher, which is the greatest commandment of the law?" "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul. And with all your mind, this is the great and the first commandment. God must come first." How do you love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind? It is by thinking about him when you wake up. The first thing you do is not just touching the phone in order to see which message somebody has sent you, if people have thought about you. The first thing you do is to kneel and pray. If you have to touch the phone, it is because of the devotion that you have to listen to. That is the first thing. If God is supreme, is the first thing you think about in your life, then you are going to make sure he's the one you think about when you are at work. You are going to make sure he's the one you think about even when you get upset. When you are angry. Before venting your anger on that person who made you upset, you think about your God and say, "God, how would you react to a situation like this?" Speak to God first. Speak to God in your heart, because he's the one you love with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind. You think about him with all your strength. Don't waste your strength on anything else. Waste your strength on God. Let him decide over your situation. Let him decide over what you are going through right now. Don't let human reactions decide over your situation. No, let God decide over your situation. If he is the one you love with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your might, then he's going to be your guide in everything that you do. He's the one you end your day with. Thank God we have the good night messages. Let the good night message be the last thing that you ever listen to, that you ever follow in the social media. It will cool you down. It will settle you with a blessing and you sleep. I'm telling you, you are going to avoid so many nightmares in your life. Then a second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. Learn to love your neighbor as yourself. How do you love your neighbor as yourself? It is getting into the shoes of other people, learning to be sympathetic. If a person has lost a person close to him, think of it as your own loss. This is the principle of humanism of Kaunda. Kaunda's humanism, putting man as a center, was based on the love of neighbor. You shall love your neighbor as you love yourself. I followed Dr. Kenneth Kaunda, the first Republican president of Zambia, in his political philosophy. Even when I was very young, I remember one time in 1988, he came for the rally in my district in Kasama, and he held that rally at the President's Park. I remember listening to him, and he spoke about the Bible, and he said, the Bible says, love your neighbor as yourself. And he said, I'm not preaching religion. This is pure politics. The politics of humanism. Putting man at the center. But wait a minute. This was a Christian who learned to apply the Christian principles even to what is seen as dirty. Politics. Politics is not that dirty. No, it can be very Christian. When you take it with Christian principles, it can be very religious when you take it with religious principles. And Jesus wants to stress this horizontal relationship, the way we relate to one another. He wants to say on these two commandments, love of God and love of neighbor, depend every religion. A religion which has no love is no religion at all. And we want to say, Lord, we are ready to remain men and women whose identity card is love. Love that sympathizes. Love that feels with the other. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Friday to you.
Thanks be to God.
This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me. And I this is my day.